the first ever gay lesbian chamber of commerce, and all the queer rising also, I represent them. My people, Natasha, Jetta, Poulan, all that fight for our rights, which I am debt to them. And what we mean, this is about love, right? And marriage equality. You know, I'm a youth community pastor, but one thing I learned is that we gotta love one another is the least that we do. We're not loving each other like the way we're supposed to. You know, Jesus says, love God with all your heart and all thy soul, right? And what he said, the second commandment, he said, just follow those two. He said, love others is what?
As you love yourself.
So when Reverend Diaz is not representing the clergy, he's definitely not preaching love. He's not preaching love. Because we got to love. That means he don't love himself. So that means we got to give him, show him some love and not hate. So maybe he needs to know how much we love. But I want to thank you this opportunity. But not only that, it's because in the Bronx, we are the most population lesbian couple living in the Bronx. And I want to say to the senators, all of them, those that did vote it and those yet to think, don't think about it. How would you like that somebody comes to your home and invade it? Well, you know what? Trina was a good friend of mine and her partner, Rosie. I was going to do the ceremony, but unfortunately, Trina died like 2-3 months ago and never had that opportunity that she deserved. And what happened to Trina and Rosie? What happened to Rosie after the death of Trina? Trina's family invaded her life, her belongings, and Rosie didn't have no rights whatsoever. Please, do the right thing. Vote for all those that passed away that they didn't have the right to get married. Do it for them, in their honor. Do it for your family that are LGBT, because every straight person has a what? A LGBTQ family. So say yes, because of all the women that are raising their children with their partners, we deserve that much. God bless you.
Thank you.